We are currently in a situation where Armenia is an occupied country. It's just that the new times are very hybrid times, and this is why we can still gather and speak out. However, in reality, we are leading our struggle through a resistance movement. And thanks to the fact that we Armenians are scattered across the globe, we are able to lead this resistance movement by using a certain logic of networking. This resistance movement must have a logical ending. In other words, we need to be in a totally different reality so that we can implement the ideas that we talk about. That is, ideas that will help us take a leap, ideas that will help us make paradigmatic changes, be it in foreign policy, army development, etc. It is obvious that whatever we say might be used against our people so long as there is no logical ending and the critical mass of Armenians in Armenia and the diaspora have not been awakened, are not aware, and are not taking actions to make a change. In this sense, the time is coming for this. Through our daily activities, we are bringing the resistance movement close to the critical point of mobilization, after which there will be exponential growth. Of course, for the time being, the growth is difficult, but it is evident. However, there will be growth in the future because the global situation is changing drastically. For instance, yesterday I read the news that Iran is resuming the nuclear talks, and this is based on a mutual agreement. This means Iran is coming out of the blockade, and it will create tremendous opportunities for Armenia. Of course, it will take a while for Iran to start showing the full capacity of the North-South transport corridor, but the fact that it will not happen overnight serves as an opportunity for Armenia because Armenia may have different roles to play. However, again, all these opportunities will simply remain opportunities if Armenians fail to lead the movement.
Բաժանորդագրվեք ազգային ժողովրդավարական բևեռի YouTube-յան ալիքին։